Khan. Welcome to Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, The Making of Harry Potter. I'm Ivana Lynch, and I played Luna Lovegood in the Harry Potter films.
And I'm Marcus Bessa, one of the product designers of the LEGO Harry Potter design team.
And we hope you're ready for a magical adventure, because we're about to take you on an exciting tour of some of the best sets of the Harry Potter films.
And give you some details on how we transform these amazing sets into LEGO products, and maybe even share one or two building tips.
Shall we?
Let's go.
Welcome to the Gryffindor Common Room. I say welcome, I've never actually been allowed in here.
Well, me neither, but I wish there was a Ravenclaw Common Room. You know, I'm a Ravenclaw.
That is maybe the least surprising thing about you today.
And you know why I love this room? Is that it was one of the main inspirations of this LEGO set that I have right here. This is a magical trunk that you can open and build for your own adventures.
I want to open this door and to play with advanced potion making.
Aww. Yeah, exactly. There's a ceremony here with Professor McGonagall in the sorting hat. Then you have the great hall with all the food, and then you get to create your own common room with all the details that represent who you are as a wizard. But it's all about just creating your own stories.
I love that, and I see there's lots of little bits and pieces of people.
This LEGO set includes a lot of minifigure parts that you can mix and match and create your own version. So here I am as a Ravenclaw little student. Do you want to give it a try and maybe create...
Create me?
Yeah.
Well, I might start with this because I am actually a Gryffindor.
And you know, on that note, I have a building tip to give all about personalization. When you're building with LEGO bricks, there's no reason to follow the rules step by step. There's so many opportunities to mix and match things, take it apart, rebuild it, make it your own.
What do you think?
Like that, exactly. It's perfect. Hold on to it because you might need it later.
Curious.
Let's go.
Welcome to the Ministry of Magic.
And what a grandiose movie set this is. This is one of my favorites, with the beautiful green tiles and the red details. It was exactly these cubicle-like offices that we tried to recreate with this LEGO set.
And I see a cheeky bit of pink in there. Is that who I think it is?
I think it is who you think it is. Humbridge's office.
Oh, no, take her back. Your side.
And you know, there's a lot of spaces inside these rooms that really invite for a lot of role play. To achieve something like this grandiose and this vertical with a LEGO build, you can actually do it very easily by just breaking it down into sections. Mm-hmm. And that leads me to the second piece of advice to share. Break down bigger builds into smaller challenges. Don't overwhelm yourself with taking on a challenge like this from the get-go. Build it separately, and then you stack it all up together, you create something this grandiose. Planning a little bit ahead goes a long way.
Wise words. Speaking of planning, I had a plan to take us to Dumbledore's office. How do you feel about that?
I would love that.
Let's go.
Look at this, Dumbledore's office.
I love this set.
It's amazing, the amount of details all around us.
Yeah, sort of Gryffindor?
Yes, the Pensieve right there, it's incredible.
Beautiful.
By the way, what is your favorite Harry Potter movie set?
Actually happens to be this one, because this is where I did my screen test.
Wow.
And I felt really safe and calm here, and I think that helped me get the part.
That's amazing. That's the perfect segue, because we have right here the LEGO version of Dumbledore's office. And it's full of these little details, just like this movie set, because it's so important to sparkle those story moments. For example, the little baby phoenix here, reborn from the ashes. And on that note, I have a third piece of advice to share with you at home, and that is focus on the details in storytelling. The more story elements you can embed in your builds, the more opportunities for role play with your friends and your buddies and your parents you have, and that will enrich your experience with a LEGO build.
I have learned so much today. I feel like a better LEGO builder already.
On that note, I actually have a challenge for you. Are you up for it?
Let's do it.
Let's go then. Welcome to the LEGO Harry Potter Building Challenge. And I thought it would be a great opportunity now to put into practice all the great things we learned throughout our journey.
Personalize your build, break down your complex builds into smaller builds, and focus on the details to make your builds more engaging.
Awesome. Do you still have your minifigure with you?
I do, and she comes bearing all these snacks.
She looks very hungry. And you know what? It's the perfect time now to actually get to customize your very own LEGO Magical Trunk. We have all these LEGO bricks, plenty of colors and accessories and stickers. Are you up for the challenge?
I am. It's a lot, but we'll break it down and we shall start with a trunk.
Perfect.
Now, my LEGO build is just about done.
It's wonderful.
My trunk, I feel it would be all about creating coziness, a cute, eclectic space where people can come and hang out, eat cake, catch up on Quibbler articles, and just feel at home.
How about the colors outside and these graphics?
Gryffindor for me, and Ravenclaw as a little nod to Luna and to you.
It's really incredible, and you can see that you really took the lessons that we spoke about and the tips and applied to your build, so well done. It's been wonderful to hang out here with you at the Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, but I really gotta go now. They're waiting for me at the LEGO Con.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you so much for teaching me all these tips and tricks and for helping me with my first trunk.
You're very welcome, and keep building. You're really good at it.
Thank you.
Gotta go. Bye.
Bye. Mischief managed.